Do you know the map?
What?
Do you know the map?
Which
Desert Strike?
maps?
Desert.
Oh yeah.
Desert Strike. Yeah. It's an arcade thing, and you pick which units you want to play. It's a lot of fun.
Yes.
There is something wrong with my microphone. Now it's working. Okay. Awesome. Good.
I'm in the game inside you.
Yeah, let me see. Was it on NA or Europe?
No. Now I'm on Europe. Yeah.
Ah, I see. Okay, I invite you to the party. Good, good, good. Okay, so let me just put that one there. Okay.
If my line gets cut, it is fine. It will just like be back very fast.
Yeah, like last time.
10 seconds. Yeah.
Okay.
Because I just have to go turn it on and off and just cut it.
Okay, that's no problem. Okay, let's straight jump into your TVP then.
Yeah.
Awesome. I just saw this guy went into carrier. Wow.
What happened?
Yeah, that's really what I was asking myself. What just happened in this game? Like one base carrier.
I think that he was a bit bad.
He played a really strange build, to be honest.
You
so
know,
yeah.
Carriers are weird if it is your first time going against them.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because at first I killed those things.
Yeah.
What are they called? Interceptors.
Yes.
But that did not help at all. All I had to do was go straight and just kill the...
That's the problem. I just saw your game and I immediately went into the test map to see how strong the carrier actually is. And basically, no matter what composition I used as Terran, I always lost on even supply. Which is so strange.
Do you know what I did? I just went for it straight.
Yes, that's what you need to basically do. But with the launch interceptor, they are with the ability to launch interceptors far away. Those
interceptors are air also.
Yep.
So I think the best thing is to just do mass Viking.
I tried that, and Viking is... If you go for the interceptor, Vikings doesn't work at all. So what I tried is Liberator do really well against the interceptors. Widow Mines can work as well. But you seem to need a combination of things in order to win.
Okay, so how is my build now, the 1-1-1?
Oh yeah, let's see. I just
when
saw...
When do I get the other guys? I just put it up randomly.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's. I will go into the notes. So with the build you just played. Let me see. I just did rewatch Maru's game.
Yeah, that's what I did also.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm not quite sure if he went for barracks first or gas first, as it is not really clearly seen. But I think it was Rex first. So. Yeah, you go.
I don't think that it really matters, because I can just put 3 on gas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the timings will be the same.
So it's not a big issue here if you go gas first or not, but as Maru just went for barracks and you go for your gas, that's fine. So that's normal. Everything good
and when
here.
When is the other gas?
Basically on 17 supply.
So now. Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
And when do I go orbital? That is an issue that I had.
As soon as possible, basically. So.
But I need the money to make troops constant.
You will have the money. Yeah, haha. You get this. You see the supply depot you built?
Yeah.
That's the money you are missing for your orbital command. You don't need that supply depot right now.
Okay.
So the 19 Supply depot
Knight in
is
supply.
that's not correct for the
So
build
knight in
order.
supply, that is when you, that's when you go for it. The orbital.
Yep, 19 supply. So if this SCV, which is currently building, finishes, then you go for the orbital command.
Okay, IDC, let me reconnect.
Yeah. So the orbital command and the factory start at the same time.
I made this gas by luck, other gas, just because I had.
Okay. But it's really
Am
good. It's totally on. Yes, you're back. It's totally on point, the gas. So that's really good. No,
I'm
no,
out
you.
Now. Wow. When it's at night, I don't know why it works during the day.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm back.
Okay, so let's continue.
So I should have went right now for orbital command.
Yes. So instead of going for the supply depot, you fire up the command center into an orbital command.
And do I put 3-3
yes.
on the gases?
Yes.
All
you,
the time.
You need that. In
okay,
this
and
build,
here I want
yeah.
for one. No, here I want straight for my. Straight for my reactor.
Okay. I think.
I know it's not safe, but I just went for it. Yeah?
So. Mm-hmm. Let me just see what Maru did here. Yeah, Maru did not go for the reactor.
Yeah, he went first for one.
For one marine, yes. And this marine basically is important to scare away the probe, so that the probe won't. The probe will get in and see the double gases, potentially, but it won't see your follow up, so he doesn't know. He shouldn't know, is it double factory or 111?
And here, because I built those depots, I was a bit low on money.
Yes, that's the thing.
But it was fine, like I had the...
Yes, you had still quite some units there, and the timing was still quite decent, I would say. That's true. You are missing a widow mine, and later we will see how important this widow mine could have been against
so
the void ray.
One. So I make one, then I go for tech lab.
Yes. What it does is you have the widow mine, and the tech lab will roughly finish at the same time with the starport, so the tank and the medivac can be built at the same time. So they will finish roughly at the same time as well. Okay. And then as soon as you have the widow mine, the tank, and 6 to 8 marines, you push across the map with 3 SCVs as well for bunker and counter repair.
Okay. So I don't know, bunker is a bit weird.
It helps a lot. You basically need the bunker. It's so strong. Like
but
1,
it
2, or
no
3.
Has no base here. So I'm not going to build the bunker on the ramp.
I would still build it, yeah, down the ramp right here on his
good,
side.
He has a good, army right now to fight.
Yeah, he has a lot of zealots, but with
zealots
the...
are good against Marine.
Normally only if they have the charge upgrade. Like that, you can kite for days against those with the stutter step. So, shoot back, and the zealot without charge should never ever reach your
How
marines.
How is my build? I went for medivac,
mm-hmm.
tank,
yeah,
cyclone,
yes,
and then I built a liberator.
Awesome.
That will join in the fight.
Yep, perfect.
And not the other medivac.
No, one medivac is enough. You don't need that much healing. The liberator is super awesome against any ground unit, and all the medivac basically is just to pick up units like the tank or the cyclone
yeah.
if in danger. So your build basically is really
it's funny
good.
Because first he built both the gases.
Yeah,
then
and then
the
nexus. Exactly, that's a bit strange here, and. But the Widowmine would have been so good against the Zealots. So you can kite back, and the Widowmine deals awesome splash damage. You clean this up nicely, but you would have lost way less Good pickup there. And now imagine this with the Widowmine and the three SCVs for counter repair.
Yeah. I didn't expect his to hit that hard.
Yeah.
Because it's the first time that I go against these many.
It's also really strange the build he's playing, like one base carrier. This is really strange. But basically you did a good job here. Pressuring, you are ahead in worker, you are ahead in army.
It's my first time trying this build.
Yeah. And that's the sad part. Now you lose.
Void Ray.
Yes. The Widowmine with the Marines or the Cyclone would have killed it immediately. The Widowmine would have dealt 180 damage to the Void Ray. And then it would have been on 70 hit points. And with the Cyclone and the Marines, yeah, they would have killed it immediately before the Liberator would have been killed. Why can't I continue? Oh, you're dropping again. Never mind. Yes, that's sad. Even focus fired, I think, the tank. And now your push basically is over. You lost the Liberator and the tank.
And I have 1,000
minerals, yeah. Yeah,
because even with...
So in the meantime, you could have gone for more barracks and the command center.
I went for one more axe.
Yes, so there are two potential ways to follow your push up. You can either stick on 1-1-1 and go for a command center, or you throw down two additional barracks and constantly produce and stay all in with your push.
Okay. After now, the game is easy because I just went for mass Viking. Though my micro here isn't the best. Just because there's this one Void Ray that made things hard.
Yes, this Void Ray saved him like crazy. That's the thing, Void Rays are really good against basically everything you had. But the Marines. So, this Void Ray is...
to do some damage with the
tanks. Mm-hmm. It's risky against a Void Ray.
Both live.
That's really good. You also scouted the Fleet Beacon, so either it's Tempest or Carrier. And normally I would say Tempest, but he really went for Carrier, and that's a bit strange.
Yeah, I don't know why I could not pick it up.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I see. So yeah, you have a lot of overmans. That's a huge problem. So if instead you would have just macroed up the whole time, I think you would have won right here.
But I don't have those skills to macro.
Mm-hmm. Do you use hotkeys for control groups for your production facilities?
You can check here.
I don't have the overlay, the standard overlay. I have another overlay, so I don't see those.
I put, you know, everything on 2.
Okay.
Commands, orbitals are on 1.
Okay.
And the rest is on 2, and I use tab to go in between.
That's good.
No, I mean, I had some troops being made.
Mm-hmm.
I just did not build anything inside my base.
Yeah, exactly. So, maybe... you could later on, not now. I still think you would need to focus on macro a lot. Like your orbital command is high on energy and your production facilities are late. But you could try to get used to use the control groups. Like if you push out
that's
to constant produce.
Upgrade for it.
Mm-hmm. Normally you wanna go for infantry weapon upgrade first. Before the armor upgrade.
Which one? Infantry?
Infantry weapon upgrade, not the armor one.
Because from my point of view, if you live more, then you do more damage.
Normally, yes, but as Terran, especially with bio, the stim pack boosts your attack and movement speed. So you will benefit more with stim from the attack upgrade as you will from the armor upgrade.
My issue here is that I had too many tanks, and he had air. That's why I did not win on this push.
Yeah, going for more tanks while he's on air, that's. I think
Because
Widow Mines would have been way better.
I didn't think that at this point he would have went all air. I told myself maybe I'll have one or two void rays, which is why I made three. Which is why I made
Yes.
three, yeah,
Yes.
liberators.
Okay, so normally Liberator are first off really
Yeah, I know,
bad
I know.
against Void Rays, but
Yeah,
then what is way more important, when you pushed up with your four Marines, you even scanned the ramp to see if it's good to move up the ramp, and then you moved up with the Marine and the Cyclone, and with the scan you saw double Stargate,
yeah, I know.
and double Stargate is heavy on air.
I don't think a lot like that, honestly.
Yeah, I know. While you're playing, this is so difficult.
Because he had
So many
both,
salads, yeah, as well, I
yeah,
see.
zealots. So I told myself there is a mix, and he might go into more things,
Yes.
adapts and things like that. But he just made the build most basic, yeah,
Yes.
that.
So, but still, even if he goes for adept, Widow Mines would be really good. So against both Widow Mines and
Widow Mines need a lot of good micro though.
What do
And
you
that's
mean
something I
with
got.
good micro? They need or they do or
They need a lot of good micro.
you need to spread them out a little bit, yes, that's
Yeah.
true. But you don't
Do you know
need to
what I
focus
find
fire
hard?
with them.
Do you know what I really find hard?
No, tell me.
Let's say that I put all of my bio on like three. When I have a wave that is new, I must take time to also put the new wave on three also.
Yeah.
And that takes a bit too much time.
How do you add your next wave of units into the existing control group?
I click on all of them once again and then I.
And then you just make the group again.
Yeah.
Okay.
How do you do it?
Instead of that, you can go to your second wave and select all of your new units. And press Shift 3, and then they will
Okay.
be added to the actual
Yeah.
control group.
That is what. Oh, okay. That is what I do to my buildings.
Yes,
But okay.
and the same thing you can do for your army. Yes.
Should I have went for a third base or no?
Hard to tell. The problem is you didn't really properly macro up. So normally, yes, definitely. In this
But because I
specific
didn't.
case, in this
Yeah.
specific case, considering how weak basically his army is, if you would have scouted it, I would say just hit a two base timing and try to win from there.
Yeah, which is what I did.
Okay. You can macro up behind, but he's high on tech units, like Carrier are tier 3 tech units. He goes for upgrades. But he skips his pro production, so you're still ahead in terms of economy. Normally, I would say go for a third base, of course, definitely. Like, when you had those 2k overmans, you could have thrown down two command center at
Yeah.
the same time. Wouldn't
But I
have
had no
mattered.
probes, so I don't see really the point.
Well, it's good to just spend your money basically all the time,
Yes.
and it gives you more mules, more scans. So if you have 2k mins, too much, it doesn't be, it's not bad to have two command center at the same time. Okay, so
Here
let's
I did not
see.
expect to go and see the caves.
You should win right now. So Stim does finish. You go in, okay. You focus down the carrier. Another good scan to see if it's safe to move up. But then you go for the Nexus, and this Nexus does not do anything currently. Okay, you lost quite some Marines as well. I think you should have gone immediately up the ramp, but still, it's good. What I really like is you are producing units back at home now while you're attacking.
I took out his thing here, pylon.
Yes, really good. I would also always go for pylons. Like now, his gates are unpowered. This is really good. You could kill the cybernetics core as well. That would delay his upgrade by a lot, like 2 minutes in total, and he can't warp in adapts or anything. Yeah, you did as much damage as possible for you. So it was, overall it was okay, I would say. You killed the space, you are far ahead in worker count. However, you forgot combat shields again on your Marines. This upgrade is so true. Important.
That's true. Because I had just one Rax and I did not, you know, double kill.
Maybe you wanna start, if you go for one Rax with a tech lab, maybe put the tech lab from your Rax into a control group. Like the CC one, just to remind you, hey, I need to research something there. Like every time you mule or you produce SAVs, you also see the tech lab, and then you might get reminded you have to research something.
Okay. Here I just went in to kill one.
Yes, good focus fire, I think. And it was worth it. So the carrier takes a lot of time, it's super expensive, killing those is always good.
I don't know how I did not win the game from here.
Let's just see. You could go in, basically.
Wait, did I go in? I'm not sure if I did.
So far, no. You took another base, so that's fine. You scan a lot. That is really good. Always being safe. Can I attack? Should I attack? Not overextending or going into a fight you can't take. A nice focus fire with the Vikings here on the first carrier again. But you see how strong the interceptors are.
Okay. Interceptors.
Yes, they are. They are so strong. So, instead of suiciding units to the interceptors, I would just back off. Like,
or go and kill it.
Okay. Yes, those are the two things. Either focus fire it or go back. What he did is
receptors have too much health. That's
yes, and they deal a lot of damage. So you need the only way to really kill interceptors is like with good upgraded bio, Widow Mines or Liberator. Everything else doesn't really work. At least not for me. I tested it in the test map just before the lesson, and Liberators did really good against the interceptors. Widow Mines were okay, but they can backfire quite a lot, so it's risky. And for Marines, and you need a lot of good upgraded Marines.
I went
Marines.
For just to kill the main ship.
Yes.
I didn't care about them.
I would normally go also, if possible, kill the carrier, focus it down.
Yeah.
But what I wanted
at
to
this point, I just knew that the game was done.
Mm-hmm.
Because I took out his second base.
Yeah, sadly he has another base and a lot of gas in the bank, and in the supply you can see it's still quite even. What I wanted to say,
I have 2 ports, 4 racks, 5 racks.
Mm-hmm. Yes, your production is looking really solid now.
2-star.
You have 3-star.
Where do you see the mines? I mean workers.
If you press E, for example, I, then you see the worker count.
I?
On your keyboard.
I have 43, he has 19. So
yes, but the supply is quite even. Currently, you don't have anything to defeat his carrier. There is not much. So basically, yes, you are, in a good spot, but it's still a bit risky. Your upgrades are getting better now.
If
this
he
is
attacks
good.
Right now, I will have time to make, you know, to make Vikings, since
yes.
I had 3 ports.
Exactly. So that's
triple reactor.
Good.
When I have, you know, triple reactor,
mm-hmm.
I don't think there's much that he can do.
He doesn't really try to do anything. He plays super defensive. Yeah, you get the Phoenix, awesome. Really nice. Again, some scans.
By this time, the game was over. I knew that I should just rush for his.
Yeah, just move across the map and straight kill him. Should be the case here.
And I had here a lot of
yes.
What I did was.
So now, yeah, that's what you do. Just go in, focus fire the ships, and GG.
And it was over.
Nice. I see. So yeah, with your initial 1-1-1, basically, if you, I just did write down the build order. Like the general idea.
Thor against air.
Difficult. Against Zerg air, yes.
Mutas, I know it's good against that.
Against Mutas, it's good. Against Corruptor Viper, it's also okay if you switch to the high impact payload mode. So it does single target damage instead of splash.
But he has an E. But he has an E against. No. Tempest or against
Harriet. Yeah, against Protoss, no. Thor anti-air is not good against Protoss ship ships.
What
sadly.
About his E?
What he has against the Thor.
I mean, the Thor has an E.
What do you mean by with he has an
Click
E?
Click on it.
Yeah, yeah, that's the high impact payload, no?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you switch the anti-air attack from... If you hover over it right now, it should say Javelin Missiles Launcher.
Yes.
So this is the anti-air weapon he is currently equipped, which is good against Mutalisk, Phoenixes, Benjis, stuff like that. And if you go into the high impact payload, he switches this into single target high damage. Like he then does, I think, 35 to 50 damage on a single target. So yeah. It's good against Corruptor or big ships like Void Rays, for example. But overall, Thor is not good against Protoss air, sadly. Oh. Tempest outrange them. Carrier are too strong with the Interceptors. Void Rays are also quite too strong with the Prismatic Alignment. I wouldn't go for Thor against Protoss at all.
The main reason that I went for this game... It's just, you know, for the build, early on build, for the
yes,
one.
Yes, yes. I see.
Like how it should have worked at first, but it didn't really work.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. Okay, we can move on to the next game.
Yes. Okay. Let me just get the...
What do you think about Thor and TY had Thor against Zerg in I think one of his games.
Ooh, was quite a while ago, wasn't it?
No. It was at the Cup, Casper Cup.
Then I must have missed this game. What did he use the Thor against the Ultralisk or against Mutalisk?
It's when he went all mech.
Oh, yeah, okay, if you go mech, then against Zerg, the Thor can be awesome. Yes.
He was against, Thor against Ultralisks. It's average.
Okay, I see.
What do you think Thor against Ultralisks?
Basically, the Thor trades equal against the Ultralisk. Like
those are, of course, you know... Better, but both mm-hmm. need their own micro.
Let's just have a short look to see how good the Thor actually is. against the ultra list. Just to see, 2 minutes to know. Normally, when I tested the Thor, it traded really well against the ultra list, even though without any good upgrades. It should still, because it has a high basic attack. So let's see, we have here a Thor and here the ultra, sorry.
Can I listen?
Basically, yes, but I just want to show you the. No, wait, don't.
Oh shit, sorry.
Can I?
Okay, it's fine. I will do the Zerg and you'll do
No,
the.
let me please set it up. I will. You don't need to micro anything, here in this scenario. You just let them collide.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, so this was without attack upgrade for the Thor. So one Ultra
It's with
Lisk.
Ultralis.
Yes, so the. Okay, let's see. The Ultra Lisk had all the upgrades and the Thor was lacking the attack upgrades.
Really, all of them? He was 3-3?
The Ultra Lisk was 7-3. Like, he has the chitinous plating upgrade as well.
Wait, he can get plus 7?
Yes, with the chitinous plating upgrade. He can get up to 8 armor.
And the Thor now was 3-3? How much
Yes,
was it?
so it was 3-3 against 8-3. So it's really close. So actually, the Thor should trade equal to the Ultralisk.
So why don't you see Thor?
So in a 1v1, the Thor loses, and if it's equal, the Thor loses as well. So what you would need to do in order to win against the Ultralisk,
Is
focus
focus
fire.
fire
Yes.
because
So,
they can.
yes. The Ultralisk don't get the surface area. Now I do focus fire, and you should see that the Ultralisk are not having a good time here against the Thor. Not the best time at least. Even though it's still quite close. Look at that.
I
So
see.
that's why you basically don't go for Thor against the Ultralisk. It can work, sure, you have maybe buildings to buffer, you can medivac pick up, so with good micro the Thor can be worth it. And if you go up to 12 Thor against 12 Ultralisk, then the Thor should be better because of the surface area. But actually Liberator are just cheaper, faster and better, and that's why you don't go Thor. In a mech composition, however,
Marauder is against Ultralisks.
off creep, maybe. On creep, no chance.
Even with their, what's it called? The shells.
The sad thing is, the shells don't work against Ultralisk.
How?
The
Really?
Ultralisk has a passive ability which makes it immune to slows and stuns. You can't fungal, I think, Ultralisk as well. You can't pull them with the Viper.
That's OP.
That's pretty nasty, to say the least. It's really
Because
annoying.
the point about the, Marauders is to tank it and to fight it.
Yes, but you can't. That's the sad thing. You can't kite. At least you can't slow the Ultralisk. Off creep with Stim, the Marauder are fast enough to kite, but only off creep. On creep, you can't win against Ultralisk with Marauder. So off creep,
It's not gonna
yes,
be prepared.
but on creep, no, no chance. Not really.
This game is a very basic game, even though, macro-wise, I was a bit terrible.
Okay, yeah, let's just see what's
I
going
can
on
go
in
on it
this.
really fast, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
I went for the build of yeah. I went for my old build. Racks, racks.
Okay.
X, yeah.
Oh, still
Expand.
the Rex, the second Rex before the expand.
Yeah, and it's
Oh,
fine
okay.
that I will have. It's good against rush. Like, for example, here, he went hatch first.
Yes.
If you went pool first, It helps.
Mm.
I just love this build again, so
Okay.
I
Well,
find it a bit, yeah.
if you do this kind of build, it's okay. It's totally up to you. But what I would recommend first off is close the wall. So the reactor should close the wall here. Otherwise, the early pool you just mentioned will kill you. You are producing structures, you don't have any army, and the wall is open. GG. So make the wall and also send out. Did you send? No, send out an SCV scout.
Yeah.
This is really
Against Zerg,
important.
I don't do it often.
You should. If you don't go for the Reaper, you should definitely send an SCV scout.
What's good about this build is that you have your tech lab and your what's it called?
Stim?
Done at the same time. So you make three marines
Yeah.
at once.
And Stim is also very early, which helps a lot. Ah, you get an overlord, always nice. Free overlords, we love that. Okay. I would also go for the orbital command before you lift off the CC to the natural.
Okay.
It's a small thing, but you will generate more energy and have the next mule earlier.
Okay.
So that definitely helps.
I like to pull off my line sometimes,
Yeah.
which is why I put it first.
Okay.
And I put a mule down there
Yes.
from my first CC. I mean, or.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. I still would go for the command center into orbital first. It just boosts your economy, you know.
He went for a fast gold touch.
Yes. And you still don't know about this. Definitely you should go for an SCV scout. But defensive and army-wise, you're fine. Worker-wise, it's still quite even, so that's good for you because you have mules. And you will hit a nice timing, I guess,
Yeah.
with your medivacs.
At five.
If you play the build Bjorn is playing with the Reaper and the command center before the second Rex, what you could achieve with really good macro is this drop, the drop ships, could be done at 4:30 instead of 5 minutes. So
Really?
you would hit at 5 minutes on his side of the map.
When is his, yeah, macro-wise, I was really off this game.
Yeah, it depends also a little bit on because of your build you have chosen, but it's still okay.
Well, I used his build. I don't know. Against Dark, I think, yeah, he had the same.
Okay. Normally they go
Here, I should have moved my
medevac, yeah.
medivacs out of the way.
Normally you
Especially now,
also
this one. I didn't move it.
Yes, you basically just lose all your marines. And that's the bad thing.
But he pulled away.
Yes. Okay, let's just see what the situation was before you dropped in. Okay, so his roaches
Has
were. Where are his roaches?
two
There.
jumps.
Yes. Drone-wise, you're still even, but here's the gold
Roaches
base.
were really close.
Yep. So with this double drop, you normally don't wanna drop his main base or his natural. Normally, you wanna try to pressure
Third.
his third base. Yes.
Yeah, but I did not think he had third, yeah.
That's why you go for the SCV scout, and then you know.
Even at 5 minutes, I should SUV scout.
If you don't have a Reaper, or
Marine Scout, I don't know, yeah.
yes, Marine Scout, SCV Scout, scout at some point. Or at least what you should do is with your medivacs, like when you start here, boosting your medivacs
Halfway here.
from your natural. You can head to his third base and see, okay, on this map it's bad because there are two third bases, like the gold base and that one. But you can
Yeah.
check, is there something, and drop, and if not, go for the main base. So with the, you don't need an SCV scout at the 5 minute mark. You can check with the drop ships. or the Reaper if you would build one. So you don't have basically to go with the SCV scout. You can see it with the dropships. And then yes, you just drop on top of the spore crawler. Yeah, Stim was late. You do focus fire. This is really nice. I think if you would have unloaded here, that's also never unload on creep. Every time you drop a Zerg, drop away from creep, like a little bit off, so he doesn't see it, and you have more time to react if he reacts. So you can pull back better. It takes him more time to reach your army, and then you just unload there completely your 60 marines, and then you stim in and do your attack move and focus fire. And I think with the 60 marine drop here, if you would have dropped outside his creep, you could have dealt massive damage. Like all the circlings, the queen, the roaches, the baneling nest, the spore crawler, some drones, all that could have died to your 60 marines with the medivacs. If you would have dropped
right
there,
those are new. Those came from his three bases, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right now.
Okay.
His things.
Yeah.
And I killed two drones also, which is... Wait, can we pause?
Yes, sure.
Units lost. He lost more than me.
You lost more, basically.
Yeah. I lost more.
You lost two medivacs and 60 marines, and he lost 6 roaches, 8 zerglings, and 2 drones. So that... I have a special overlay. If I press Shift L, it opens the unit loss tab. I don't think you have it on the standard overlay, sadly.
No.
No, that's unfortunate. But yeah, you did lose more than him. And normally, if you see, oh, he has too much, or before you lose your medivacs, just pull back. It's okay. You don't need to commit to this drop.
I think he lost himself the game because he went for gold and I did not touch it.
Yes.
Exactly. My macro was bad also.
Still better than him, his macro.
But and my third base was late.
Yes, a little bit. It's okay.
5 Raxes, and I don't make more.
So you stick on 5 Raxes for the rest of the game, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah, you definitely should go up to 8 Raxes on 3 base.
Yeah, I know. I think I went to 6, and I say that's 6.
Okay.
At this point, I went and told myself, has... You know, roaches.
Mm-hmm.
So I can fight them easily, so I'll just go and push.
Yes. What you could have done, just for a thought experiment, imagine you wouldn't have lost the 2 medivacs and the marines. Then what you could have done now is do a...
Yeah,
either just go and do a big push, or do a multi-prong attack. It doesn't need a lot of attention or APM to be executed. Yeah. All you need to do is load up 2 medivacs, send them to the left side, 2 send them to the right side, and then shift click to unload maybe here if you want to, and maybe here. And then they do all the damage they need to do themselves. You can stim them then if you want to focus a little bit more. But what they will do is he basically will most likely pull all his army to one location, while the other location you can deal massive damage. And then if he is there, just lift and pull back again. And then macro.
I lost against Zerg, where I took his third base three times.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, 3 times, you know, in a row.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, first he brings it, I drop, kill it.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Again, drop, kill it.
That's good. He's producing a lot of queens, so... So, currently, yeah, now you are a little bit behind in worker supply. And as you said, your macro, you have still so many overmints, especially because of the gold base.
Yeah.
So On the gold base, maybe you could have gone up to 10 racks and 3
Because I'm not
factories
used to
even.
having
The gold
this
base,
system.
yeah, it boosts your economy over the limit you are used to, and I totally see that. It's really, really difficult to macro
Like
up.
I have two things making what's it called houses. What are they called?
Supply depots?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Supply depots.
This is looking
So
really
making
good for
more
you.
racks and more ports.
At some point, definitely, yeah, get some more access.
But I have one very nice fight. I think it's maybe the best fight I've had in the whole of the game.
Okay.
Even though it's a bit bad,
Oh,
the
nice boost there.
start is really good.
Okay. Yeah, then let's just see how this goes for
I
you.
should have killed this. I didn't notice.
Yeah. Upgrade wise, it's looking really good for you. If you would fire up to 2 now, that would be awesome. So that's why I have the eBay and the armory always in the control group with the command center. So I.
Composition-wise, playing against Roach, Ling is very good. At least,
Yes, you're looking good against his composition.
what I do is I siege my tanks here, not close to the ramp, which was smart.
Oh yeah, the tanks should be exactly on, like, next to the bridge. That would be an awesome position for the tanks. But it's still good. I mean, look at
And
the
I killed all of
banelings.
his banelings.
Awesome, exactly. That's because of how he went down. Look at that. He's donating so many units to you. And he's fighting still in the liberation zone, so wow! Yeah, and you have better upgrades as well.
He got stuck here, I don't know why.
He was, I think, attack moving to get the liberate. I don't know
Yeah,
exactly.
yeah.
Something like that. But yeah, you
I should
basically
have moved
crush
my
him.
tanks though, but yeah, it's fine.
It's okay, you move them now. They dealt lots of damage, like 7 kills, 10 kills. They did really good here. The Liberator, look at them. 16 kills, 17, 10. And now you go in again, the Cyclone dealing damage. Liberator, he doesn't have Ravager. Yeah, that's looking really good here. So
I have
far.
one thing which I have resented to ask. Against like Zerg, every time that I fight Zerg, I should like siege down and poke. You know what I mean by poke?
Yes. So you go
So I should
forward
never
slowly.
all in as in go in and try to end it right there. Siege and poke.
Yes, I think so. So it depends on in this situation you are in a really good spot, but now he's making so many circlings, it w your army is really s Oh, okay. You got lots of army here and here
Yeah,
and
I just
here.
kept here.
Okay, I see. If that would have all been together, you could have, as you said, just go and push it and win.
The game ends in soon. The game ends in exactly one,
Yeah.
minute.
So that's fine.
So I move them eventually.
Yes. Right now. Awesome.
So one thing I have to ask is, when I'm playing TVZ,
Yes.
at sort of what point do I move up all of my troops towards his base and I start to try to push slowly, slowly?
Okay. Let me see. Give me a moment, please. Okay.
Because he had five hatches. So if I just waited a bit longer, the game would have been over.
Also, he was going for Ultralisk, and this can be difficult to handle. Yes. His bases. Normally, in a TVC, what you wanna do is prevent his fourth base from happening.
Okay.
And so, in this case, it's okay to pressure the gold base, because that's the nearest one and the most value one. So with the big attack, what you do is, if you have tanks against Roach Ravager, or especially no against Ling Bane as well. You push back creep. So he that's the first task. Almost never fight on creep. Try to push creep back slowly. So on creep he's way stronger than off creep. And what you then do is push forward slowly with tanks or widow mines, liberator, and always poke. Like you take 5 to 6 marauder or even all of them, depending on the situation. And just the marauder. Stim in, attack his hatchery and force him to move out into your tank line. And then you pull back. And you do this over and over again. And then when he pulls back, your marauder go in and with the concussive shells, they slow down the enemy units. And then you kill them off. Slowly but surely. Over and over and over again. Until he commits. And then there's the big fight where you need to stim and split and micro your tanks and all of that stuff. But up until then, you don't really go heavy in. Like, not in his face. Just shaving up.
What I did.
Yeah, shaving off layer of layer from the Zerg army. Until it's so small that you can kill the base. And push
when
further.
When does Zerg get their fourth base?
Normally, let me think about... They get the fourth... yeah, it depends on what they want to play, but between 6 and 8 minutes can be the case.
Wow.
Let me see. I can tell you exactly when it should get down. Let me see.
We can end this game and just play.
Yep. True. So hatchery. I would say yeah, hatchery. Blah blah blah. It can be yeah between 6 and 8 minutes depending on how the game goes. Oh, is there anything else we might try? We still have some time left. Or anything you want to... Oh yeah, okay. The TVT.
Playing against T is why I hate this game.
Mm-hmm.
I love playing against Zerg and playing against Toss.
Mm-hmm.
I hate playing against
them. I see that. TVT is... can be very... meh to play.
Because
so
every time I go for port,
mm-hmm.
double medivac, and they go for tanks.
Yes.
So I'll have 2 vacs, marines. I'll have like 15.
Mm-hmm.
He'll have 1 tank. He'll have about 6 to 8 marines, and he'll have 1 medivac, and I'll just lose the game.
Yes, I see. The problem is the 60 marine drop, it can work against Terran, but normally you will clump your marines and the tank just kills everything.
Yeah.
So instead, I would say go for a different build. Go for a 1-1-1. Basically, let me see. TVT. If you want, I can show you a build I am playing.
Okay, sure.
Replay? Yes, I do have lots of replays. Let me just get a build I was playing here. Where do I have one? That one? Panda? Yes, that should be fine. And
you lost two games.
Yeah, one was against a 6.1k MMR GM. He was like rank 40 GM. And the other one, I don't know, Terran. The good thing is I put on a great fight against him, so I don't have to feel better about it. He was like 1k MMR above me, and I still managed to hold on for like 15 to 20 minutes.
Are you gold? I mean, grand? Master,
no,
or...
no, I'm just Master League. Tier 1.
So there's no Grandmaster.
Not for me, no. So what I do is, I'm the Blue Terran.
Is this that game?
Yes, this is the game. So I go for the gas first, like he does as well. Then the barracks.
What minute is the gas?
It's super early. It's like like right after the supply depot. Even before the supply depot finished, look at that. 30 seconds. Bam. Refinery.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay.
So 15 supply, refinery. And then it should be 17 supply racks. I think. Maybe 16. 16 supply. Okay. 16 racks, 17 gas as well.
Don't you find the racks is today? Because.
Sorry, your internet was quite bad. Can you again?
Don't you think the racks is a bit late? It goes for fast.
No. If you go, it's totally fine. That's why you normally, like with this build, I am safe because I open up with a fast Reaper myself. Gas First is basically going for a fast Reaper. I mean, he could proxy it, but if you
but
proxy
you
Reaper.
Go, I mean, Rax and Gas at the same time, and by the time that your Rax is done, you will get one fast Reaper.
Yes, true, but. Even against a 3 Rex opening, this build is safe if you know how to micro.
So you want basically Reaper into factory.
Yes.
Second gas was at when?
17 supply.
And you got your orbital at 19 supply.
Let me check. Like
yeah,
as soon
I
as the Rex finishes.
You know,
okay,
yeah,
okay. Yeah.
Up.
Yeah.
So around 19, 18 supply.
Yes.
And you did not send SUV.
Not in this case. With this build, what I am currently playing, I need every single bit of income I can get. And I know I'm safe with my own Reaper. So if he goes for a 4 Rex, this could be difficult to handle, but it's still doable due to the Hellion. I don't really need to scout for now, because what I do is I stick for a 1-1-1 myself.
You went for 1. Hellion.
I will go up to 3 Hellions.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Why did you go for tank?
The tank is the tank is too defensive for me.
Okay.
The tank, well, you will see I will move out with the Reaper and the Hellions. Right now. So and now I have map control.
He did the same thing.
Yes, that's the standard TVT build nowadays. This is how you play TVT. Lots of Hellions and Reaper early on.
Tank evac, won't that beat it?
One base could
no,
be
not
difficult.
One base, two base.
No, two base, I'm completely fine. I got a Liberator right now. I'm fine. I will get a Cyclone behind that as well.
He has, you know, other things. Marines.
And now I go in, look at that. And I can deal awesome damage. Like I get the mules, I get the SCVs, I get up his ramp. If I would have microed better, I would have won right here. Liberator in his mineral line, dealing lots of damage. I'm misclicking a little bit here.
You failed the Liberator.
Yes, but he still got 4 kills, it's enough. I am now 10 worker ahead, and I had an army supply, and he has lost mining time. I will get one more kill with the Liberator. And behind that, you see, my command center is almost done. I
you
got
should
a,
have not lost the Liberator.
I don't lose the Liberator. Okay. It gets away.
So how did you lose?
Follow-up push. I will now saturate my base. Go into tank evacs with... No, not tank evacs.
Why
tanks.
Break this?
I do this because if I need to micro, it sometimes happens that I attack moves to this location and then I click on the bricks. So if he drops there and I attack move and I click on the bricks, my marines will attack the bricks instead of attack move to his army.
Okay.
So it's a safety measure.
Wait, did you win this game? No.
I do win this game, definitely. I should.
Oh really? Because I thought that you lose this game.
No, I should definitely win this.
Let's say the time that your first push comes out, that can we just go back to your first push?
There was. You mean the
your first push
with the yeah okay.
Yeah.
need to hurry up a
First
little
off,
bit
let
now.
me check one thing. Factory doesn't have any add-on.
So far, no, no.
Okay, by this time, if he has a tank right here at the how do you ping? Q
Alt and G. And then on the minimap or everywhere. Yes.
If he has a tank right here, isn't your push over?
Yes, but
So
most.
why did he not go for tank? Safe move.
He can't, with the tank, he can't really hold the low ground. So he would be forced to stick on high ground on his main
But
base
then
for a
he
long
can move
time.
it to the ramp.
And then I can attack it with the Hellions and the Reaper with the grenades. One tank is not that scary against Hellions and Reaper.
Oh,
I mean,
but
sure,
scary
if he
against
has a
Vive.
tank, then
It's really scary against
I
Vive.
you need to see the whole picture. Sure, if he has a tank, okay, but I have the Liberator. So I can force him to unsiege, and then the tank isn't as strong as it was in siege mode. So I have the tools to break basically everything. Not the Cyclone. The Cyclone is the only thing which counters my build. But in this case, it's late, so I still do lots of damage.
And can I ask you one thing? When did you go for your add-on? That's the push.
So after the three Hellions, I go for the tech lab, and after the Liberator, I go for the tech lab on the starport.
What about the racks? When do you go for the reactor?
After the three Reaper.
After the three Reaper, okay.
Yes.
So it's three Reaper and three
Hellions.
Hellions.
Yes.
Okay.
And then I repair the Cyclone and Liberator and
If you
everything.
went for one base.
Me or he?
He.
Yes. No big problem normally. I mean, I open up 1-1-1 myself, so I can deal against one base quite good as well. So what he does now is he's sending out Banshees, dealing massive damage to me. He has all, because he's setting up two Banshees at the same time, he deals really good damage. But
This
he's
is why he's
still.
good, yeah. Turrets.
Yes, they were too late. I didn't thought he would go for both Banshees at the same time to hit me. And now I push out and I get the prime position behind his rocks. I have the Vikings and the Raven for the PDD. So with the PDD I can push away his Vikings. He can't win the air battle, so my tanks can kill everything. And he basically will lose the command center here.
So it's over.
Yes, it should be over any second now. He loses the CC. What I do now, and that's one thing you might wanna try as well, is I see, okay, I lose the Viking battle now. So I just back off. Bye bye. I killed the command center. I'm massively ahead. You see it in the
How'd you
supply?
lose the Viking battle?
I lost the Raven, and then what I did was I had three Vikings at home instead of rallying them across the map. So his production eventually caught up with my current Viking count. But it's no matter. If you look at my army and his side of the map, he doesn't have anything compared to my army.
And I think you went for a late third.
Quite late, yes. I am very aggressive with my style. So basically it's some kind of two base push, which then I take a third base later on. My
Where did you go
upgrades.
for your second base?
The second base, let's see. So let's just shortly look and then that's GG, you see. So the second base, let's check for that timing. Yeah,
Okay.
in between, so 3:35.
So just before your push.
Yeah, you could say that.
Okay. And why don't you go for Marauders? In
Marauder
your last
are
push,
not.
you
No, no,
just
no.
have Marines.
Marauder only against mech. Otherwise, marine tank. Marauder are not good against marine tank.
But they're good against tank.
Yes, but not against the Marines. And they take two supply, they are expensive, they don't have that much DPS compared to the Marine. You just don't build them.
Okay.
Against mech, yes, but not against bio tank.
Okay.
Okay.
Can you go to the last push a bit?
Which one? On the ramp or the really last push?
The last one.
Okay, yeah, sure.
Just so I can see your amount of racks at this point.
Mm-hmm. Sure. So now I'm on six barracks.
I have two tech labs.
That was because of the stim and combat shields.
You get them both at the same time.
Quite at the same time, yes. Normally what I should have done is one barrack should have produced a reactor and the second factory should have used that tech lab instead. You're right, that is a mistake. And I should go up to eight barracks, of course, as well, but my macro was bad in this game.
You have one port also.
This is okay. One port is enough. In TVT.
Two ports is twice as good.
If you have the money for it, yes. But if you constantly produce units, normally you don't have the money for it.
Inside most games, if I have one port, I find myself a bit back. That's
yeah, if you have one port and you lose Medivacs and Liberator all the time, then you need basically a second one. If you can preserve them, then you don't need the second one. Unless you want to go for Liberator range and TVP or TVC, of course.
Well, okay. Alex, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. I hope it helped.
Is it paid? Because I did not get a mail from them saying.
No, I will get the payment in like 2 days, so it's totally fine.
No, I'm just asking.
Yes, it's paid.
Because I did not get the mail.
Oh, okay. Maybe you should check for on your. I don't know if you did credit card or PayPal, but definitely it should be paid. I will send you now the notes I made for this session, and then I will upload this video on YouTube, if you're okay
the
with
last
that.
Then, which one? Of us? Yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care.
Awesome, super. And then I wish you best of luck with your upcoming ladder sessions, and if you need any
TVT
more coaching...
TVT helped the most by far, because TVT is my worst matchup.
Yes, it's just practice, and if you need any more coaching, feel free to book anytime.
Kufas and Zerg is easy, it's just about, you know, a macro play for me at least. Build-wise, it's fine.
Yes, I see, okay.
Okay, well,
awesome.
Thank you, Alex.
Yeah, you're welcome. Have a good one.
Talk next time.
Yes, I'm looking forward to it.
Thank you, bye.
Bye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.